Welcome once again. We are studying Psalm 91 and we'll continue from where we stopped in the last session. Verse 5 says, "You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday." So, here the psalmist is enlisting the dangers in life, and he's pointing out different kinds of dangers. You know, he says terror could come our way, arrow, you know, something that is pointed at us could come our way, pestilence, again, you know, sickness and a disease can come our way, and destruction can come our way. And he is also stating that, you know, as if in different seasons, different challenges come to us, many of these things could try to approach us. But, you know, he is telling us that when we dwell in the secret place of the Most High, when we rest in the shadow of the Almighty, none of these things will get close to us. Oh, that is so powerful. That is so powerful. And we do not have to fear. In verse 5, he begins by saying, "You shall not be afraid of the terror by night." Now, sometimes we think that it's only the destruction that is bad enough. But, you know, even the fear of these things happening to us, sometimes the fear itself, the anxiety itself can keep us in a place of bondage where we are tormented by fear. But the psalmist says, no, we don't have to be tormented by fear. We don't have to be afraid and worry and say, oh, what if this comes against me? You know, what if I experience terror? What if I experience some arrow pointed at me, or pestilence or destruction? You know, before this verse, he talked about the truth and shield of God being our double protection. So, you know, we have to do the right thing. Of course, you know, we walk with wisdom. We're not saying that, you know, we can go and do anything we want and still God's protection will be upon us. And then we can confess these verses and say that, you know, I will not be afraid of any of these challenges. You know, as long as we are doing what is right and as long as we are dwelling in the secret place of God, now, there is no need for us to be afraid, because the psalmist is saying God's deliverance is a mighty deliverance. And this is a promise that we can claim. You know, we can speak these words of confession in our prayers, and we can say, "God, as I'm dwelling in your secret place, thank you that I do not have to be afraid, oh God. Thank you, God, that none of these evil things, Father, will come and have any place in my life, because you are my deliverer. You are my protection." Can we say that together, church? Let's go ahead and say that in prayer. Father God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you that, Lord, we have this privilege, oh God, that Lord, we can hide in your secret place, that, Lord, no weapon of the enemy, God, can get to us. And God, today we stand and declare, God, that, Lord, we are protected, Lord. We are delivered by your mighty hand, Father God. Thank you, Lord, that there is no place for fear in our lives, Lord. Lord, we stand with boldness, God, and fear will not torment us. We are protected. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.